Hello, dear friends. Welcome to a commentary channel. Now, I did say I was going to take a break, and I was messing around with AI and just having fun and uploading that, my creations. But something has come up recently that involves one of my friends, but it also plays on me because it's a trauma and it's toxic, dysfunctional families. And I wanted to explore this. My mother said to me when I was 17, "I've never loved you." And a few years ago, after Rob died, I tried to get in touch again because I've been estranged from my family for 20 odd years. And after my father died, I thought I would make another effort to try and get in touch with her again. And I got a phone call from my sister to say, "Your mother wants nothing to do with you." And of course, I got hurt. And we do get hurt because people who know us know what buttons or triggers to push. And I wanted to bring this up. I could say to you, "I don't like you," but you listening to me say, "I don't like you," you are assuming that I don't like you. You're not inside my head. You don't really know whether I like you or not. Just because I said, "I don't like you," I could be just lashing out because I'm having a bad hair day. So what I'm saying is we get so traumatized by he said, she said, and they can say these awful, horrible things, but we're not in their heads. So we make assumptions that they don't like us, they hate us, or they're jealous, or whatever. But we're not in their own head, in their heads. We're only in our head. We only know what we think. That's why they say, "Assume us out of you and me." So when someone says something hateful or horrible, don't take it to heart because you don't know what's going on in their head. For example, if they say, "I don't love you," maybe it's projection. Maybe what they're really saying is, "I don't love me." So what I am saying is we can say all this hateful, horrible stuff, and it's just lashing out because we might be experiencing hurt ourselves. I have a very favorite saying, "Hurt people hurt people." Let me repeat that for you. Hurt people hurt people. So people with baggage are going to project their own traumas onto you. And especially if they know you and they know, if I push this button, "I don't like you, Jem," that Jem has a self-worth issue and she's going to take it to heart and I'm going to get hurt. But they're not hurt because they've just pushed my button. If you, for want of a better way of looking at this, look at it as a game. Look at it how people interact as a game. And it's all about power and control and winning. So every time someone pushes your buttons or triggers and you get hurt, they win. You've just handed them control. And what's worse is you've got to live in the now. Stop living in the past. And every time someone has said something in the past and you're going over it and you're spiraling and you're looping and you're just hurting yourself, if you think of it as a game, they're winning. Because they're not there wherever thinking, aha, I've hurt Jem. Jem's now hurting Jem by repeating what someone else has said to me. I've now spiraled and looped. Oh, they don't like me. And as they say, actions speak louder than words. So what people say to you, you don't know what they really mean because you're not in their head. You don't know what's going on in their head. But if they behave a certain way, then you do know. For example, if I come up and I punch you in the face, that's obvious assault and obvious I don't like you. That's obvious. But for me, just to say I don't like you, I could be lashing out. So we carry so much hurt and so much baggage because we don't love ourselves and we let other people push buttons that will, you know, push that button that says Jem isn't worthy. You know, she is not worthy. She has no self-worth. Push a button, I don't like you. Jem internalizes that and says, Jem, they don't like me, therefore I'm not good enough, I'm not lovable, I'm not likable. So do you know what you have to do? Is you have to like yourself. And if you can just think of that as just noise, it's just noise, and just live in the moment and live in yourself and know you, your own speech. So what's inside your head, what's talking to you is true. But what someone else is telling you, you're not in their head. You don't know. Actions speak louder than words. So if I gave you a box of chocolates, that tells you I like you. But if I said I like you, you don't really know. It's actions. If I do something nice for you, that's showing I care for you. But we've got so much damage because words hurt. Words are poisonous. And we're all going around carrying this baggage and this damage from family. And sometimes families or loved ones or even friends can say things and they don't mean to say what you think. Sometimes what I'm saying is that you're misinterpreting what they say. You're taking, because of bias, your own bias, what someone says, you've automatically put your bias and prejudice on what they've said. And they may not have meant it exactly how you have taken it. And sometimes we take things out of context because of our own baggage and our own trauma. So what we have to do is love ourselves, live in the moment, and realize that hurt people, and that it's all a game. I remember when Rob was alive and I used to get really angry, I would do damage with words. Yes, you punch someone, that leaves a bruise. But you say something horrible, and the emotional damage can last a lifetime. But if you don't listen to that rubbish and just say it's mirroring or self-projection, you'll lead a happier life. If you say, I am of value, I am a good person, who cares what anyone else thinks or says? And if you are giving and kind, and you can show this with actions, actions speak louder than words. So if someone came to me with some money or with a gift or even offered to take me for a drive or listen to me on the phone. That says a lot more to me than I like you or you're nice or you're beautiful or whatever. I have a cleaner who not only does she do a good job of cleaning, she gets me gifts and she says I'm the best boss she's ever had. And I know that must be true because she wouldn't give me a gift. So I don't listen to what people say. That's just noise. And you're putting your own interpretation on it. So if you are in this situation, because families can be toxic, so can friends, so can work colleagues. Anyone can be gossipy, yucky, dysfunctional, horrible person. But don't dwell on it, because remember, I always tell you, the past is history, the future is a mystery, and you don't want all these people to stop you from living your best, happiest life. You be true to you. So if you're in this situation of someone has hurt you, you can write a letter to that person, and you don't have to deliver it to that person, but pour out your feelings and also write a letter to that hurt little you and say that they didn't mean it, they're projecting. And maybe they do mean it. We don't know. You are not in their heads. You are in your head. You can only know what's true for you. I don't know what's going on for my next door neighbor or for my mother or my daughter. I observe and assume, or they may tell me and I still assume. I'm not in their heads. Does that make sense? So this is what I was hinting at the other day when I uploaded a paranormal video, that I was going to talk about toxic families, because families do so much damage by saying so much spiteful, hateful things. But it's to get a reaction out of you. And as soon as you reacted, they scored and they know that's your button. So they say something, you react, oh, they know what to do next time. We'll just say it's a little bit similar. And that's your trigger. Press the button and you react again. So stop reacting. If you stop reacting, you don't give them what they want. I hope this has helped. As always, love, light, and blessings, and cherish every moment, because you don't know when your life will end. So live your best life and live your life for you. Nobody else but you. And I'll go back now to my computer AI and have a bit more fun until I get another person asking me to do a topic about something else. And also to let you guys know that next month I start with Smart, so these types of videos will be less frequent anyway. Have a good weekend. Bye for now.